you your message. I am very sorry. But God, this year, next year, there's no difference in God. We might seem like a year is just a year, but to God, a year might could seem like a thousand years. And a thousand years in a year. So may you really receive that blessing. God has opened up the year of 2022, and He has allowed it. With the most important content and goal, God has called us. How must we live on? Yes, we must live hard, or in effort. We must really work hard for it. And every New Year's, we make a resolution and in front of God. It is rightful that we live with our effort and our hard doings, hard works. But just because we live that way, can we really have true success? What is true success? It is knowing the correct direction of God. And it is setting our direction, matching with God's direction, and that is true success. Then where does this God's direction come out from? It is given through the message that is given every week, through the pulpit. That is where the exact direction of God comes out from. And God has given us the answer that we must hold on to. And it's saving myself with the blessing of the throne. And it's blessing of the throne, saving the church. And with the blessing of the throne, this must be flow down to the fields. And God has given us the direction for our church. Holding on to the word of Isaiah 54:3, we must concentrate on our next generation, and we must do 24 in healing, and we will do the 24 in 237. And holding on to the blessing of the firstborn, and we will take possession of that land. You must not lose hold of the pulpit message that is given every week. And through the word, God will give us the direction for that week. As we start this new year, so that we do not lose hold of the word, we will start the special early morning prayer. And holding on to that answer, we will start this new year. And holding on to that answer, we must see how God fulfills that work. That is why we must not lose hold of the stream of the word. And inside the word, what is the most important thing that says in the Bible? Inside the Bible, it is saving the 237 nations. And because everybody is diseased, we must heal them. And we must raise up our next generation as the summit. This is the direction that God wants the most, and what is spoken in the Bible. And that is where we must go all in inside of the 2037 nation, next generation, and the healing. But with our own strength, can we really enjoy the next generation healing and 237? We cannot. That is why we must receive the blessing of the firstborn. And that is why we must have the establishment of the throne of God. I bless you in the name of Christ that this start of receiving the kingdom of God and next generation healing in 237. Then what is the blessing of the firstborn? We must first hold on to the blessing of the firstborn. You know what a firstborn is. It's a person that is born first. To the people who were born first, they were given the double portion of blessing. We also had this one culture. We always thought more importantly of the firstborn, and we gave them more of our inheritance. Then, who are the people who are spiritually the firstborn? We are the people who are firstborn who have received salvation and become the people of God. Now, why do we need this blessing? Because there's three reasons. Right now, it is the age of darkness, the culture of darkness. And as the time goes on, the more darkness will come. Inside the Bible it says, in Isaiah 62, it says, "For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people." And if you see in 2 Timothy 3:1, it says, "In the last days, there will come time of difficulties." And the endless corruption will arise, and people are stressed. And many people fall into depression and anger. And they have anxieties, and people are continuously committing suicide. But this problem doesn't just come. This is the spiritual problem when the darkness covers the earth. But this darkness and the spiritual problem has become a daily thing. The whole field are covered in darkness. The problem of Genesis 3, 6, and 11 will continuously become greater. That is why the world needs healing. Now, why do we need the blessing of the firstborn? Secondly, because our next generations will face more difficult problems. It is the destruction, it's the age of destruction of our next generation.
Yeah.
If you see in Luke 23:28, Jesus said to this to the disciples, but this is what we need right now. It says, daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and your children. Right now, it is the age of destruction for the next generation. We know the word of Jeremiah 4:4. Because there is no one to quench their thirst, they're dying. Because no one can give them bread, that is why they're starving and they cannot move. It is that age, and Satan is attacking our next generation. What you see in 2 Kings 8:12, it says to Hazael, and says, crying to him. But this is already told by Elisha. In the end, it says, little ones, it says, dash in pieces their little ones. They will kill their young men with the sword. And rip open their pregnant women. He said, they will rip open the person that is pregnant. This is the destruction of our next generation. That is why we must give the correct answer. Right now, different organizations are arising and give them the wrong answer. That is the wrong transcendental meditation. They're saying, go inside yourself and open up your brain. And they're saying, empty yourself. And say, receive the energy that is given from the universe. The space is the Lord, or God, and I will become that God. And that is the ideology of the New Age. And then if you see Matthew 12:45, you see that seven demons will come inside that empty place. That person will become more difficult. Age by age, this corruption, the age of corruption began. There is a growth inside the Korean church, but is that growth really a growth? The Church of Europe, the 99% of the people were Christian. But how is it now today? Because of the COVID-19, the churches are shaking. The people that are now prepared with the gospel and faith, they're all falling away. And more changes will arise inside the churches. And the churches of the world are following after the churches of Europe. Because the era of destruction has come. the people, if you see in Exodus, the Israelites became slaves and they were captivated. If you see in Acts 6:18, the churches will fall and they become colonized. And the mid-age churches all fell. And this destruction is keep on repeating itself. That is why through evangelism and missions, we must stop the fall of the church. What Elisha wanted from God was the blessing of the firstborn. And Elisha knew the crisis of all Israel. And to save them, I need the blessing of the firstborn. How am I going to save the age that has fallen in darkness? How can we save the fall of the next generation? How can we save the churches that are being destroyed? God wants to give us the blessing of the firstborn today to all of us. Because God wants to save everyone, that is why God wants to give us this blessing of the firstborn. All the seven remnants enjoy this blessing. So Moses, what he enjoyed was to destroy the the destruction of Egypt. And what Samuel spoke, not one word fell to the ground. And that blessing that Samuel enjoyed was the blessing of the firstborn. And the early church, it might have seemed like people who are lacking gathered. The politicians of Rome tried to crush them, and people with power like Jews and Pharisees tried to kill them. But that people, those people changed the age. And if you see in Acts 2, 1 through 4, that's the blessing of the firstborn. This year, really pray. I need the blessing of the firstborn. With the blessing of the firstborn, let us save the church and save the 237 nations. And secondly, and with this, what must we do? Where must we do 24? We must do 24 hours to our next generation. We must know that the next generation that God raised is not just our next generation. Through them, the work of God will rise. If you see in the Old Testament, the Israelites were held by the world, and that is being colonized or captivated to Babylon. If you see in Isaiah 6:13, the remnants will remain. And if you see in Isaiah 54:3, is that through our offspring, through our next generation, God will restore everything. God will restore the church that is being trampled by the world. And through the next generation, God will fulfill the work of recreation. And that age of the remnants are arising right now. Just like seeing the sky, and because of the clouds, it might rain, that's why they ran towards it. So we must run towards the field that is covered in darkness. This WRC, 74 different nations have gathered. And those places are being introduced every week. And the remnants are arising, and we're connecting them. And we're giving them and showing them the fulfillment of the Word of God. Inside the church, it's the same. And through the people who hold on to this gospel, it's relayed to our next generation. And right now, the summit school is still taking place. And now, for summit school, people who want to enter into summit school, they might have to take a test now. And for raising our next generation, our remnants, our RUTC is taking place. Why do we need this system? We must see it as the important plan of God to raise the remnants. God wants to raise the remnants. And God wants to let them know how much. If you see in the book of Deuteronomy, God wants to stake our lives and tell this to the world. It's like God told us to constantly teach this to our next generation. We must stake our lives and really proclaim this gospel. When this gospel wasn't relayed, they became colonized and enslaved. Then there, what kind of blessing will God give us? It is in the book of Deuteronomy 6:11. Let's read together. In verse 12, then take lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of the lands of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. This is the blessing that God will give us to the people who relate this gospel to our next generation. And so you will have, your houses will be full of all good things that you did not fill, and cisterns that you did not dig, and vineyards and olive trees that you did not plant, you will gain that.
저주와 멸군 빠질 때에 하나님은 반드시 언약자가 누구에게를 일으켜서
Every time the age of destruction came, God raised up the remnants who held on to this covenant. And God raised up the few remnants who held on to this covenant and changed the age. We must not teach them anything else. Right now, our Sunday schools, it's very important for them. Even if they do not understand, or even if they do understand, we must continuously teach them the gospel. It is the great work of God of three transcendences. And it is the three unlimited amount of power of God. And it's the three work of God. It's the nine things that is taking place inside of the blessing of the throne. And this must be relayed. This is why our church stands right now. That is why God is extending our lives to really proclaim this gospel. That is why inside of our prayers, the next generation must be there. And we must really pray for our lay workers and our pastors. And inside of our prayers, the remnants must be always there. That is when we are, our direction matches with God. And the lay leaders and the pastors must be inside of our prayers. And through that, all the Israelites came back to the Lord. They did not just save the churches, they saved the nation and the world. And there's one thing that they did. David held on to the covenant and really raised up the remnants. And he transmitted this word to the next generation, the remnants, to block the future disaster. If you really raise up one remnant correctly, then they will block the disasters. And they will save the age. If we really hold on to the correct gospel and relate this to our next generation, we don't know what God will do. God is holding our next generation with His right mighty hand. And that is why we must quickly make them find their talents inside of God. And have the future camp. And when this future camp and the talents they find inside of God takes place, then God will raise up our remnants to block the future disaster and raise them up as the witness. And may you become the main figure to raise those kind of remnants. Second point is healing 24. Inside of today's passage, it says, the offspring will possess the nation and will people the desolate cities. Right now, all people are diseased. The first age was age of welfare. But Rome was gospelized, but that actually became the problem. And the next age was the age of separation, the age of division. But right now, it's the age where all people are diseased. And you can see that inside the Bible, people are anxious and in a haste. And as time passes on, people are start to split and separate because of their own will and because their own thoughts. And they're always in loneliness and in pain. And everything will become quick. And they will become hasty. And because of that, all people will crumble. And the age of mental illnesses come, and the three organizations are held on to this, and through the movement of transcendental meditation, made the Nephilim movement. And through Paul, you can see the three works that he did. You can see in Acts 19, they hold on to the culture of idolatry and held them as inside of complete darkness. But God wants to restore the image of God. God wants to raise or restore our spirit. Because we lost hold of this, the three organizations came out with this. They say, you can raise up your potential power, and even the Buddhists are holding on to this. But only Christians lost hold of this. That is why we must really raise up the awareness and the healing of our spiritual things must arise. And we must have the restoration of the blessing of Eden take place inside of our lives. And so we must do prayer 24. We must not lose hold of the rhythm of our prayer. We're receiving the word. Whenever we open up our eyes, what do we think about? We must pray so that thinking about the field that we will go to and really hold on to it so that the blessing of the throne will become upon me. And when we meet people, that is the daytime. And during that time, we must change our standards of seeing everything. If you really have the summit time during the morning, then during the daytime, we must change our eyes to see everything so that we can save them. I must stand up as the witness first. So what time is that? That is the time of healing. We really have the summit time, and we must have the time to save, and we must have the time of healing. And riding this rhythm is healing. As we really enjoy this healing, we can heal this age. And saving the people from the darkness. I bless you in the name of Christ. You guys all enjoy this blessing. And lastly, it's 237 missions 24. In today's word, for you will spread abroad to the right and to the left. God has given us this from the beginning. If you see in Genesis 1:27, God has given us the cultural mandate to the people who have the image of God. And if you see in Matthew 28:18-20 and Acts 1:8, this is the cultural mandate that God has given us. This is this must become my life. But this doesn't match with me? No, I must match this with the world. We always think to ourselves, this doesn't match with me, so God must match with me. But that's incorrect. Because of those thoughts, all things were taken away from them. Because they lost heart that God made all of our sons and daughters wander. And God has made the Israelites match with Him, making them enslaved, captivated, and colonized. But in the opposite sense, if we really match with God, then God will pour down blessings. God said to Abraham in Genesis 12:1-3, He said, there is no one that will overcome you. If you see in Acts 13, Acts 11, God closed the door but opened up the door to Macedonia and told Paul that he must see Rome also. And this is all the works that God has opened up to the people who match the direction. What does this mean? We must hold on to the covenant to save the 237 nations. And that to do that, we must raise up the remnants. And we must become the place where the 237 people can come and receive training. We must become the place where the people of 237 come and receive training and become a disciple and go. And we must save the TCKs. And we must become the antenna where we can connect the 237 nations. The content to block the darkness of and Satan inside of the field, we must really prepare our spiritual content and spiritual system. And there, God will bring all of the blessings. And God will bring all the people here. Right now, the contact free has become contact. That's why we must have a system where contact free becomes a contact. People know BTS. In LA, they gave a concert, and through all the world, 20,000 people gathered. Right now, BTS has captured all of the online systems. If you see Bill Gates, Steve Jobs. From a long time ago, they started making the contact free as a contact. We must really pray for our church. We give people a lot of money and we are preparing our we are preparing the church for the 237 nation and for we're making that system. If you see the book that Moses wrote, that is contact free, and the letters that Paul sent, that was also contact free. But through that, a lot of disciples arose. Time has gone by. I will come to a close of my word. The lay leaders and the pastors really hold on to the word of 70 places, and all of our believers hold on to the word of 70 disciples. And because through online, the contact-free system, this has become possible. You must know that this has become greater and stronger. Satan has conquered the world through contact-free. Contact-free system, but with the contact-free system, we will save the age and the remnants. And through the message that's given online, they will receive answers. If you see Paul sent letters and people received answers through that. And through that, real disciples arose. There was a celebrating. Well, and somebody was keep on speaking, but I saw that this one person was translating and spreading this throughout all of the world. And this newcomer graduation ceremony was taking place, but that was also sent through online. But through this, there might be people that will be fall out. But this can become the method of God, where only the true disciples stay. Who will conquer the age of the contact-free age first? We must really see the work of God and go out to the field. And maybe become the people who are used greatly by God wherever He wants. God, we give you thanks. Please let us save our next generation, 237 nation, and really heal them.